Tonight, as we get set to listen to this course, before we enter, tonight we are reading from Anand Ramayana. Anand Ramayana, not Tulsidas Ramayana, is a text that was written by Valmiki, the same sage that writes Valmiki Ramayana. But this particular text focuses only after the destruction of Ravan. It begins after the war, on their trip home to the city of Ayodhya, where Sri Ram and Mother Sita become king and queen, and what happens thereafter. In the text, there are many discourses that are not contained in the other versions of Ramayana that you and I have grown accustomed to in Trinidad and Tobago. The discourses that are dealt with here, for example, in the first part, as the reader goes from chapter to chapter, Sri Ram is actually advised by his guru, you know, Ravan was a great bhakt of Lord Shiva. He was a great devotee. And regardless to the reasoning, you destroyed that praying person. Sri Ram, you should purge yourself of the sin. You should go on Tirat and pilgrimage. And he goes from place to place for a very long period of time doing puja. Mother Sita accompanies him, and they all use it as an opportunity, as a reason to pray, to offer prayer, homage to great saints and sages, etc. And as the book continues, you will hear about various katha that deal with the children of Sri Ram. For example, we know from Tulsidas Ramayana that he has a son, Lau, and another son, Kush. But in Anand Ramayana, it tells you about the wedding of his granddaughter, Hema. Just in Valmiki Ramayana, we never, for some young heads, they don't know that Sri Ram had an elder sister, Shanta. There were different discourses that are given to understand the history and the katha of our Lord. Tonight, we'll use this text to understand one part of our dharma that sometimes people take for granted in Hanuman worship. Prem Swarupa Pauna Putra Hanuman Ki Jai. Whenever we go to puja, whenever we are in maybe different moments, we are always bombarded by Hanuman worship in one way or the other, and sometimes people don't understand why. People don't seem to know. For example, have you ever seen somebody putting up a roof, and on the roof is a little red piece of cloth or a red flag, and plenty of people ask, Baba, is it correct that we have to put, how we call it, tapa on? Alcohol punching, is that what is supposed to be done for that, whatever that is, for safety, for safe passage, is that the procedure to do that? At different times, if you go to your market shed, you might see a red piece of cloth hanging in the ceiling, in the roof. And people ask, what is that about? Today we had puja. The gentleman sitting right here, the bamboo was 50 plus feet, Jai Vishnu, high up in the sky. Why is it, easy question, why is it the Hanuman flag is always taller? Now bear in mind, you are the person who is having Hanuman puja by your home. You're the Hindu. If someone comes and says, how come the red flag is always a little higher? What would be the answer? Tonight in this text, the worship of Hanuman is being questioned and at the same time answered. The focus here is on his worship and why do we do some of the things that we do. In this text, a guru and a shishya is discussing as the text has gone on about different things, these two individuals are now discussing. Could you please tell them? As the chela is asking the question, why or how do we worship this form called Hanuman? Why do we worship him in the way we do? These things that are offered, these things that are given in dan and charity, why is it given in the way it is done? Brahma says, my dear son, I'm helpless. I cannot solve the problem. I don't know what is the problem. I don't know where this great sickness, this calamity, it is as if it is never ending. I don't know where it is coming from. Therefore, I do not have the ability to fix it. Let us go to Lord Shiva and seek his assistance. For those of you standing in the back, it have many seats in the front. They go to Lord Shiva and they beg him, please intervene. Please help us now. There is no help. There is no way. There is no assistance from anybody. And everybody is getting sick. Everyone is falling ill. When they say Vata and Pitta, different categories using scripture terms, Vedic terms, meaning whether circulation, stomach, blood infection, skin infection, all types of problems. Every description, it was there. Lord Shiva, in various katha, we hear of the different rudras. We hear that Hanuman is the 11th incarnation of Lord Shiva. What about the 10 incarnations before? What about the 10 before that we sometimes miss or don't know? But we know Hanumanji is form of Lord Shiva. Let's agree. Lord Shiva turns just as he did. We hear about the Satnarayan Katha where Bhairo Baba is form, where Lord Shiva pulls one strand of hair and he instructs Bhairo Baba, may you do my bidding. In a different time, he turns to Virabhadra and he says, may you go and destroy the Yagna of Daksh Prajapati. When he held the body, the burning body of Satima. No, he turns to these forms called the Rudra and he says, go upon the earth and protect them. Go. Without delay, go and accept a form that would help the earth regenerate. These forms that they had assumed were the Vanar, the monkey, half monkey, half human. Lord Shiva says this form will assist by their posture, by their mudra. They will become Amrit Sajivani. By their presence, they will bring health and help to those amongst that are sick. For this reason, O Brahma, when people are worshipping, from now till the end of time, people will worship the monkey. In all of the forms of creation, everyone will revere this form that I create with human features, but sometimes monkey characteristic. For children to understand, I'm saying monkey characteristic. If I say Vanar, sometimes children may not understand what I'm saying. Scientifically, in the Homo erectus form, we are Homo sapien. The Homo erectus form, the description of the bone structure, the jaw, the features, what we describe in the science books, we see it in living form in our Hindu texts. He says, go create this race that by their duty, by their behavior, they will remove sickness, trouble, difficulty. And because of this, people will adore them by erecting their flags, by doing offerings, by giving them different types of fruits and beverages. These Rudra will always be there to help and assist. Prem Subala Pavana Putra Hanumane Ki Jai. When people go to worship this form, it is said, O Sri Ram, as Garuda is saying, from ancient time, people would maintain the murti, the physical form of the monkey. and by feeding his form, by maintaining the various gifts that are given, people get blessing. Sri Ram says, "Oh Garuda, please tell me, when and how is it these forms would be able to help the village, the family, those that are ailing, etc. Please give me a little more detail." Everybody, let's join together as Sri Ram is learning about some of the people that he's associating with. Tell me if you've ever seen some of these things, and today you'll understand why. Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shakti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai Namo Namah Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu
Shakti Rupena Samstita
परिवर्वात प्रवक्षयातम मुनि मंत्र पुरा ये निज कर्मा ये तत्र ये कर्ता ये तम
says, when the village, when the family, when there's an outbreak of sickness, for this reason, on the Ekadasi day, on the 11th day in the new moon, a person should get up very early in the morning, having prepared themselves, having bathed, etc. Go. And where the Vedi is, where the altar is, offer flowers, red flowers to the form that is depicted as a monkey, as what we call Hanumanji. He says, "Oh Sri Ram, if these forms are worshipped with the orange sindoor, with the red sindoor, with the haldi powder, not only haldi, but haldi powder, and various flags are erected, different types of problems are going to be evaded." He says, when a person has sickness in their home, let them raise a flag for Hanumanji, and different types of sickness will be evaded. When a person, as a farmer, when there's hardships for food, when there's drought, when the market stall is under pressure, let a red flag be erected where food is being sold, where market stuff is being sold, and the proprietor, the person that is selling, will see their way. The food will last and people will get nourishment. He says, when a person is under duress, when a person is under the attack of enemy, let a flag be erected over their doorway, and this red flag will protect them from enemy, from thieves, etc. When a person has different type of back related problem, spinal related problem, shanigra, all types of retardation or mental problems, special needs children, special need people, on four-way junction, plant flags for Hanumanji, plant flags that will ask for the protection, for the upliftment of families that have these special children, and these changes will come. When there's kidnapping, when there's rampant pain, suffering,
difficulty when the men in the family are constantly dying. One of the remedies, find where there's a five road junction, and on the 5 points, you erect 5 red flags, and these problems can be overcome. He says, when the prayer is done, you bring the guru, worship the guru, washing his feet, using Rudra mantra. If it is simple, Om Namo Rudraya Namah, there are more elaborate mantras. He says, O Sri Ram, when this is done, sickness and problems can be evaded. The 11 forms of Rudra that Lord Shiva commanded to go upon the earth, Hanuman, Sugriv, Nal, Neel, Sushain, Jamwant, Angad, Dadimukh, Tara, Tarala, Mainda. These forms that surround you now, O Sri Ram, they are the forms of Mahadev. They came to support you. They came to be with you. And for this reason, Prabhu, I'm asking, how you called for me and they were here. Blessed is the person that would use these forms in whatever work, in whatever they have to do, they would be successful. Whenever people have to climb on great heights, such as the roof, let them use the red flag for null. But let them use RT, camphor RT. And that will be sufficient as the worship at that great height. When a person is moving anything, why do we use the red color? In the form of Sugriv, please allow me to be successful. Even in that instance, alcohol is not to be used. In everything that we use, let me be successful. Hanumanji, for children to understand, I bow to you, O Vanar form. I bow to you, O Ishwar. I ask you for your permission to move with the tall bamboo, the piece of wood, to put up this roof, to climb on a great height. Whatever it be, we have jug in the temple. Please allow us to be successful. Whenever you go and you see people having yagna, isn't it a common sight? We put flags along the roadway. And some people think that is to guide the person where the yagya shala is. No, maybe that is the case for some. But the truth is, go and you will see on the junction where the two flags are erected on either side. And you are asking Hanuman Baba in these forms and others, please stand there and protect from that point, from that junction, from that main entrance, whether four road, T-type junction, three entrance, or two-way junction. Please allow everybody that is coming here to be positive and protected. The yagna is about to start, the prayer is about to go, and we start with you, dear God. May you bless the roadway. May you bless those that will traverse here, so that as they travel, may they be guided and protected. For this reason, his flag is uplifted at that time when the yagna is about to start. Prem Sabala Pawana Putra Hanuman Ki Jai. Let's hear what happens in this last verse in this section.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shakti Rupena Samsita Namasasye 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 Namo Namah Yadevi Sarvabhuteshu Shakti Rupena Samsthitam.
Shri Adi Shakti Mata Ki Jai. In this last verse, Garud says, blessed is the person that whenever they are doing any type of chore, that whenever they are doing any type of work, that whenever they have any type of murti procession, any type of walking, that the color red would always signify that Hanuman, those 11 forms of Shiva,
and let those Shiva, those Rudra that protects the devotee from sickness, from difficulty, from trouble, allow them to always walk with you. Sri Adi Shakti Mata Ki Jai. This is why people dress in red, people wear red flag. As we get ready to have many events in the country, different groups are holding chanting of Hanuman Chalisa. Devi, it had a concert the other day for Devi Ma. San Fernando Hill had a wonderful yagna. The Hindu as a group have embraced their culture and their practices in a way that we've never seen it before. The flag of Dharma is flying very high. Now, in the comfort of your home, on a daily basis, people look at, thanks to people like Sankhya TV and their sponsors, they look at satsang, whether here or abroad. You listen to your satsang on the radio, you watch it on TV, and wherever you are, he wants the girl for himself. So he goes in a huff and a puff, very angry, and he says to Lord Vishnu, "You see how cruel you are? You put a shrap on me that I look like an animal with human features. I put a curse on you, God." Here where you reach, leave Vaikunth, leave heaven, and go on the earth and be robbed of the person you love. And go and seek assistance from people that have monkey and human features. Go and beg them for help because of the cruelness you've shown me today. Prem Sabalo Siyapati Ramachandra Ki. That is where the Ramayana with Sri Ram started. That Sri Ram would play the part of a normal husband in the woods, illustrating love and separation, pray, constantly praying. In this regard, today he's listening to Garuda. He's still playing the part. He's surrounded by these powerful, powerful emissaries. And even here now, there's another question. He talks to Garuda and he says, "So why is it the Hanuman flag has to be so tall?" At the beginning, we hear of the guru and the shishya who are talking. They ask, "Why is it the Hanuman flag is so tall? Why is the emphasis there? Could you please tell to me this discourse?" And he says, "For you to understand the power of Hanuman, who Hanuman is, please listen. That this discourse deals with the meeting of two great individuals. One was very proud, and one was asked to break that pride. Let's join together as the answer about the flag of Hanuman is about to be revealed. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah. Narayanaya Krishnaya. Everybody. Paramatma in a moon, a
Narayanaya Krishnaya. Paramatma in a moon, a
Samyak Prishti Shivayatha Hanuman Dware Rudrayati Kailashnath Kritaye Tena Krishna Krishna Ye Nata Ye Ati says
when Krishna was walking the earth. Krishna was walking the earth. We are still in Anand Ramayana. He says, Arjun has embarked upon great pilgrimage. He's going from one tirath, one place, to another spot, from one spot to another spot, doing puja. Great war is coming, Mahabharat war is coming. Arjun is guided by Krishna, go and do puja and collect all the weapons that you can amass, so that when you get onto the battlefield of Kurukshetra, you will be ready. Arjun is going to end up meeting Mahadev Baba. Lord Shiva is his end point. And as he's going, Lord Shiva is very wary of his Nitya. Lord Shiva is always there on his side, O Shishya. When Lord Vishnu is in Ram avatar, Lord Shiva is there in all Ivanar, helping him do his work. When Sri Ram had to cross the ocean, it was those forms that take and build the bridge to reach Lanka. Now, Sri Vishnu is in the form of Krishna, and Lord Shiva is again assisting. What does he say? Oh Hanuman, come to Kailash. Please come to Kailash. I have a message for you. When Hanuman goes to Kailash Pati and he bows to the Lord of Parvati, Mahadev says, go meet Arjun and talk to him, work with him, but break that pride. He thinks to himself, he's too powerful, he's too great, he's greater than Sri Ram even, he's greater than everyone. But if that pride is not abated, if that pride is not broken, he will be destroyed on that battlefield. Go, O Hanuman, go and do the bidding of my will. Hanumanji bows humbly to Sadashiva and he goes to that southern point of India where they are going to meet. Arjun is doing worship where Rameshwaram is, and now he's drifting to the shoreline, looking at the calm water, looking at the beautiful shore, and swift as the wind, Hanuman reaches to that point. Let's hear what happens.
Rameshwar satoye dhatam mridagunaye natarkshatam sandhyasita par ye natcharitam ye na bal buddhiye ati
Narayanaya Krishnaya Parama.
Shri Vishnu Bhagwan ki jai. Hanumanji, imagine somebody sat on the beach and they was praying, eyes closed. Hanumanji comes next to him and gently disturbs him, touches him. My dear brother, so great to see you, so great to meet you. Arjun says, who are you, friend? You are calling me brother, but I don't know you. He says, I am Hanuman, son of the wind, servant of Sri Ram. That same Sri Ram who had built a bridge to go to Lanka, I am his emissary. I am his worker, Hanuman. Arjun scoffs and laughs to himself. Oh, great personality, I bow to you. He says, oh friend, you say you bow to me, but you do it in a scornful way. Have I offended you?
In a sarcastic way, when I said we built the bridge, you did as if it didn't happen, if it's not real. He says, no, my friend, I know you built that bridge. I know it was done. But I scoff at the person you serve. Please listen to what he said. The same Arjun that is on the cover of your Bhagavad Gita, friend to Krishna, is saying this. He says, I scoff at your Lord, Sri Ram. How could somebody that is so great utilize little monkeys, little forms of life, lesser forms of life, to build his pathway to go to Lanka? I simply think if he was so great, why trouble lesser beings with such a task, with such a strain? If he was a great archer, if he was God incarnate, couldn't he have built the bridge himself? Couldn't he have shot arrow after arrow and made a bridge of arrows across this body of water, reaching Lanka on the other side? Couldn't he have done that? Why did small, large, medium size, not only monkeys, but bears in the case of Jarmond, different forms of life, aquatic, terrestrial, all came together to assist him? I, on the other hand, am a great archer. Hanumanji is listening and he says, I hear the monster in this man. I understand the false pride. He says, well, brother, if what you are saying is true, I don't know better. I cannot perceive someone being so great at archery that you could build a bridge this vast. He says, believe it, oh brother, I could do it. Listening to the words of Arjun, Hanuman Baba says, let's go. There's a smaller pond, a smaller body of water here on the side of the temple where the Jyotirlingam is housed. A gut, a big pond. He says, if you make a bridge that is spanning this water, let's have a competition to see who is greater. And if you, the great archer, if as you profess to be, if you can make a bridge that could hold the weight of just my thumb, just as my finger will tap the bridge like that, if it could withstand that lash, I promise that my flag would always be on your vehicle. My protection would always be there for you. Wherever you go, my flag will always be there, safeguarding you, protecting you, keeping you safe from seen and unseen danger. But if when I put my thumb on that bridge, if that bridge break, you must set a nice fire and destroy yourself. Because of your false pride, when you say things like that, when you attack my Lord and Master, my dear friend, make sure you can back it up. Prem Sula Pauna Putra Hanumanaki Jai. Believe it, Arjun takes the bow and the arrow and he starts to shoot one after the other. Sometimes in the TV show, we see a rain of arrows and from head to tail, the arrow join and they form, for our understanding, a bridge over the pond. It is formed. Hanuman Baba squeals loudly, Jai Shri Ram! And with one touch, the bridge is destroyed. The bridge is shattered. Arjun feels abashed, but by the terms of the agreement, it is now time to destroy himself. And very humbled now, very humbly, he starts to gather wood to make the fire. And Hanuman Baba is all too happy to prove that his Ram was right for doing it the way he did it. that the name of Ram is more powerful than the archery and skill of this person. Looking on at what was happening, Krishna and Shiva want to save Arjun. They don't want to spoil him. Krishna comes quickly in the form of a little boy disguised, wearing only the lungi, only the loincloth and the janeu. He comes to speak to them. Let's hear what happens.
Jai Bhole Baba Tab Sharanam.
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 Jai Sambha Sadashiva Tab Sharanam.
Jai Sambha Sadashiva Tab Sharanam.
एक ब्रह्मचारी आत्म प्रहयाते विश्व बहुत्यात्म ज्ञान अर्जुन मुख पढ़ते पूर्वा व्रत ये पर्यातम जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम
जय भोले
जय साम सदा शिव तव शरणम
जय साम सदा शिव तव शरणम
The young boy, the young brahmachari, the young student, he comes and he says, what are you all doing here? This is my property. What are the two of you doing here? So Hanuman ji smiling says, I just want to bet. That fella thought he was the greatest archer. And he bet me that we could build a bridge. And when I called on my Lord, that bridge would take the lash. And I told him, if he could take the lash, I would protect him. But if the bridge broke, he would have to kill himself. So what you are witnessing here, he's about to burn himself because of his false pride. Because he thinks to himself, he is the doer. He is the omnipotent person. And now, because of his words, because of his thoughts, he has to pay for it. So my dear friend, witness what pride could bring to a person. Even death. The young fella, showing on his face that he was perturbed. No, 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 no. The rules. Manusmriti says, whenever a wager is going to be done, there must be a witness. Else, you could cheat him. Hanuman Baba says, the last intention I have is to rob anyone. Will you be the witness? He says, yes, this is a serious wager where a person's life is involved. I accept that role. Let us do over this bridge. Hanuman Baba goes by the pond and Arjun, as he's about to pull the first arrow, the young boy whispers to him,
Tatvarayena Arjuna, Krishna Krishna Rova Yeati, Rova Yena Dehati, Sattva Sattva Yeata,
Bhole Baba.
Says, oh friend, unless you want to die, my advice to you is realize in this moment, you cannot do it alone. If you thought so before, realize the error in your ways. My friend, before you let loose that arrow, my advice to you is to pray. Call on God. Call on that divine help. Let him help you and let him make your bridge strong. Let him be the glue in your arrows. Let him give you the strength to overcome this endeavor, and you will win that monkey. Oh friend, say your prayers. Don't just fire that arrow. Say your prayers. Call on him now. Don't forget that. And as Krishna in this boy form, in this disguise, steps away, Arjun heeded his warning. What does he do? Arjun says, oh Raj, oh King of Kripa, oh King of Mercy, come to me now. Come to me now and save me. Save me from my words. Save me from my pride. Save me now, else my death is imminent. I have said that my skill is so prevalent, so capable, but dear God, I realize that I am helpless and apless, without capability, if you are not with me. I am now humble. I saw what happened just now. Dear God, I have been given a second opportunity. Don't let me fail. Stand with me. And you know in the movie you see them praying on the arrow like this? See Arjuna in your mind praying, and he calls on Krishna and he starts to shoot the arrow.
It is Marana Krishna ye aati, Priha Priha Bahuru ye Bhatuka, Yana Arjuna Mukhaparta, Prana Prana ye Dikham.
Jai Bole Baba Tab Sharana.
The arrows started to meet, and slowly the bridges formed. Arjun says, oh brother, Hanuman, test it now. Test the bridge and see if it can withstand the weight of your finger. Devotees, Hanuman Baba says, Jai Shri Ram. And he swings his hand down, and just the thumb, and as it connects with the bridge, it bounces. He makes a fist, and he connects the bridge again, and the bridge takes the lash. Hanuman Baba says, oh, he has prayed this time. Let me test it further. He takes the mukhtar, and he punishes the bridge with the name of Ram. Arjun says, go on top of the bridge. Oh mountain, go on top of the bridge and see. Hanuman Baba mounts the bridge and jumps, letting his full weight release on these arrows, the thin pieces of sticks. Hanuman Baba has the drishti to see God wherever he is. Let's hear what happens.
Jai Bhole Baba Tav Sharana.
Everybody.
Jai Bhole Baba Tav Sharana. Chakra chakra ye atau, drishtiye Vishnu swarupam, kapiye sena prenati, Hanumanta drishtiye atau, Jai Bhole Baba Tav Sharana.
Hanuman Baba is not blinded. He says, how is it? I was able to destroy this bridge just now, and now my weight is being held up by this same arrow. He says, something is different. Something is playing here. He says, I feel my Lord is close. And Hanuman, who is blessed with the drishti, go back to Tulsidas Ramai at the bank of the Suryo River in Ram Gita. Sri Ram says, Hanuman, you stay upon you, and I'll keep a promise that I will come to play with you. For all your seva, for all your work, for all the protection that you will give my devotee in their times of need, for all your duty, for all your work that you will do, I will come to play with you. You will see me. Get ready and await my return. Hanuman looks over the bridge, and on the side of the bridge, in the depth of the water, he saw the Sudarshan Chakra spinning. The emblem of Lord Vishnu was holding up the bridge, turning. When he looks to the bank, he sees the little boy standing next to Arjun. But Hanuman has the drishti. Let's hear what happens as Hanuman standing there.
Hanuman, Hanuman, ye hi katha, madani, madani, ye bhala, Vishnu rupa bahuri tam, bahuti, bahuti, ye atau, jai bhole baba tab sharana,
jai bhole baba tab sharana,
jai bhole baba tab sharana,
everybody.
Tava Sharanam.
Prem Sabalo Pawana Putra Hanuman Ki. Imagine if it were you. Question here now. Which person are you? Are you Hanuman on the bridge, or are you Arjun on the bank? Hanuman standing on the bridge looks at the bank, and in that moment sees the child, sees Arjun, blinks, and then he sees Sri Ram standing next to Arjun, where the child is. He blinks again, and Sri Ram has transformed into the sweet smiling face of Krishna. The Mukhtar that we see him in all the pityas, so proud, holding on his shoulder, falls from his hand. As he sees his Lord playing with him, Hanuman bolts from that bridge, forgetting about Arjuna totally, and drops to the feet. The Mukhtar fell off his shoulder, fell into the water, and without care, Hanuman Baba runs and drops at the feet of the little boy, crying profusely, relating, gushing, Prabhu, I was waiting so long for you. I had given up hope. I go wherever your prayer is being read. I go wherever your worship is being done in hope that I would see you. Dear Lord, why did you take so long? He says, do you remember when we were building the bridge and I lifted Govardhan? You told me to place him in Vrindavan. And when you come back as Krishna, not only would you walk on him or live on him, but you would lift him up and he would be your sevak. He would be your umbrella. He would be the person doing service to you. Prabhu, I saw it to happen. It did happen. That person called Govardhan got that darshan. There are many examples, Prabhu, When we fought on the battlefield, Jamont was a young person, and you told him that you would play with him. Wait on the youth, I'm coming. And when Jamont, in an older stage, when he meets Krishna and Jamont fight over confusion, over a gem. And what was the benefit? Jamont prayed that he would have children and that his child would get married to somebody like Sri Ram. And Sri Ram comes back as Krishna to marry Jamonti, the daughter of Jamont. He says, Prabhu, I witnessed that moment too. Dear Lord, I have stayed here. And today, by your grace, Prabhu, why are you flashing me these figures? Today, why are you playing with me like this? Reveal yourself. And Hanuman was crying. And whilst he was crying, the little boy, that form, disappeared. He moved. Hanuman Baba got up and he spoke to Arjun with long tears. He says, oh friend, oh brother, do you know who was standing next to you? He says, your friend is Krishna. Your best friend in this life is Krishna, but you are so blind that he was next to you and you did not recognize him. He was guiding you and you are so blind. Why are you allowing your knowledge, your fame, your crown to blind you in such a way and rob you of so much? He says, oh brother, you have so much in front of you. So many great things to accomplish. So many great works to be done. But because of your false pride, none of it is possible. I was sent here to help you. I was asked to come and guide you, assist you in teaching you a lesson. And in doing so, I myself has learned a lesson. That wherever a person is, whatever a person is doing, my Lord could be right there watching me. And if I am not careful, I might miss him. Who are you? Are you Arjun, next to God and blind as a bat? Or are you Hanuman, standing, looking, waiting to see him, and able and capable to see his works, trusting him even when he's not there? He says, oh friend, please remedy your ways. Krishna now appears as Lord Krishna, and he holds on to Hanuman. And he blesses and he gives him the darshan that you will always be close to the devotee of Lord Vishnu. That whichever form I take as Lord Vishnu, you will always be the one to safeguard them. In whichever way the problem, the test, the sickness, the troubles will come, you, Hanuman, of all the devotees that I have, of all the forms that are created, you will be the one that will be given the power to protect the devotee of Sri Vishnu. Prem Sabolo, Sri Vishnu Bhagwan ki Jai. For this reason, when a person does Panchmukh Hanuman Puja, look at the form. One face is Hanuman. The other four, the Narasingha form, for example, the Varaha form, where he has the boar head. All these are different incarnations of Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu gives him the power. And he says, go and protect my children. Correlated to this discourse, there's a form where Hanuman Baba has 11 heads. Ek Dash Mukh Hanuman. On Facebook, on the internet, people were hearing where there's a prayer where you offer 11 flower, 11 clove, 11 rote, 11 this, 11 that. That type of offering is done to this 11 face form. And in a little bit, we'll say the mantra. When done on a day like today, great type of blessing is possible. Christian says, may you always protect these brothers wherever they have to go, and may you always come to their aid. Principal Upawana Putra Hanuman Aki, Hanuman Baba says, Arjun, when you enter the battlefield, put my flag above you, and I will protect you on that field. One day I was reading in the temple and I spoke about the Mahabharata discourse where Hanuman and Bhim meet. And the question was once asked, how come if Bhim and Arjun are the ones that meet, how come Hanuman, watch your Gita, you'll see him, he's flying over the chariot of Arjun where Krishna and Arjun are having the conversation. This is where he makes the promise to Arjun. He jumps up on that flag and he's flying above him. And he says, wherever my flag is flying, whatsoever is underneath is protected. He says, always keep my flag high above you and I will protect you, brother Arjun. For this reason, the Hanuman flag is always the tallest flag. The logic is this. If you never understood it, please listen tonight. Those of you at home, please remember. When you are erecting your flag, maybe the apex of the roof, the high part of the roof, might be out of reach. But the bow char, the lower part, where the guttering, the lower end, is, we always try to let the bamboo be a little taller there. The logic is, if he's flying over my home, by virtue of this discourse, he'll protect my family, he'll protect my home. This is why this is done. When you go on the junction here, when you go in different places, where you go where people have yagna, and you see his flag flying, please, Hanuman Swami, protect this place from seen and unseen danger. Protect this village from virus, from epidemic, from sickness. Sickness that is not letting go of people. Airborne sickness. This is the person, you see, America is having an outbreak of measles right now. That is an airborne virus. Just as how everybody right now has a stomach flu that is rampant. That is, it is as if it does not want to leave the people. Now is the time for Hanuman worship. He's the son of the wind. When things are being spread by the wind, we turn, as the Hindu, we turn to him. And we ask him, please remove these things from the atmosphere. We are living under duress because of that dust. Do you know how many children are having asthma attack? Skin disease are on a rise. Go in the hospital and see how many skin problems, rashes, because of what is in the air. When the Hindu is praying and they are praying to Hanuman, Hanuman Baba, bless the air that I breathe. Bless me to breathe. Bless me to live. Bless me to function. When children are addicted to Symbicort and Ventolin and Sabatol, just to breathe. And they don't know, parents don't know what to do again. The Hindu prays to Hanuman Swami. He says, put my flag and I am there. I will protect you and your family. This is why, my dear brothers and sisters, this is why it is like that. When you see his flag, what you do? You bow. When his flag is worshipped properly and he's standing there, the troubles would go. Mahabharata Katha says, when the Parva of Bhagavad Gita, the entire volume of that Bhagavad Gita is done, and the entire Mahabharata war is done, and Krishna comes off the chariot, he says, Arjun, let me help you come off the chariot. And if the signal to Hanuman, Hanumanji, jump off the flag. The war is finished. And he comes off the flag. The entire chariot is burnt, destroyed and dismembered. All the lash, all the arrow, all the different weapons that were shot at Arjun, now the blows are shown as Hanuman Baba lifts his protection. It is burnt to a crisp, it falls to the ground. Principle of Pavana Putra Hanumanaki. It says, when the person lifts Kapi Dwaj mean the flag, Dwaj, Kapi meaning monkey. The flag that has his emblem, his name, his form on it. When a person raises that flag and asks God for the protection of Hanumanji, when it is lifted high above, Today somebody told me, Baba, I don't understand how people be putting up some small flags. So
that is because you don't understand why you are putting up the flag. In order for it to work properly, it must be above. Granted, there are some people that live in apartment. Granted, there are some people that live in different circumstances. Go and see if the little flag cannot be positioned above the doorway. What did we hear in a different chapter? When you are in the market stall, when you go in the business place, when you go in the school, when you go in the entrance, place the flag of Hanuman at the doorway. Place the flag on the car. Place the flag where you need him. And so long as he's above the doorway when you are walking in and out, he'll protect you. But if the flag is very short and you are taller than the flag, then what you are looking for from that flag, you're not going to get it. It must be above you. Principle of Pauna Putra Hanumaniki Jai. Even if it is to just hang the flag, the cloth, and not necessarily the bamboo. Hanumanji is given different forms, different passages, different praise by Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu is the person who gives him all the darshan. And what is the purpose? Go and protect the devotee. Go and protect the person that needs protecting. Prem Sabala Pavana Putra Hanumaniki